Hi, Irish people. I'll slide this in the middle of those where I'm beating up poor Amanda and Leadfoot. So we don't have anybody nagging. I'll nag a little bit on this. Getting the garage cleaned up a little bit, not too much. Need to get those fixed. I'll probably charge that battery and then fill that back up. Get that grain moved back out to the grain shed. That sweet feed, I mean, I go through a bag of sweet feed like once every 6 months because they just get like a half a cup or a cup when I give them a little treat. Sweet feed is not good to feed. And I've been feeding the cows these senior things because my horses don't eat them. And then this is rabbit food. I just keep it in these containers for the bag. So hopefully I get this off. This is all my packages that I opened. So I got to do a video on that. That's my battery because my freaking battery in my truck died the other day. Just died. $170 for a new battery. I was like, what? God, crazy. So that was my other battery that I took out a long time ago and I keep it charged because if I need some power in here and the power goes out, I've got a little thing I can plug in there and I can plug in a, it's a converter, a 120 converter, or I can charge like an iPhone or a laptop with a, where's that damn little plug at? I thought I kept it right by here. Hell, I might've moved it. I thought it was right here so I could use it and know where it was at. Hell, I don't know where it's at. I might have showed it before. Usually you plug it in a cigarette lighter. Where the hell is that thing? Crap. Somebody's probably already seen it on the wall. I got it all hanging on the wall so I can find it easy. See how that works out? Both these batteries are charging pretty good. Maybe I'll put it by my battery stuff. Darn. Anyway, I have it. If I need it, I would grab it, but it's not on a wall, I guess. Hey, Mokey Cat's eating his little food. Hi, Mokey. We're gonna say hi to the horsies. We're gonna say hi to the little horsies and cows. There's their blankets. I gotta roll them back up. What I do with their blankets for the winter, and normally for like three winters, because I rarely use them. Like I said, this first year I've used them. Well, maybe the second year. I might use them one other time. So I'll roll these up really tight and I'll put a zip tie around them and then I'll hang them up top because I don't use them. And so I got to do that. Got to hang those things. Those are on those four hooks up there. Those jugs, because I don't use those water jugs that much. And I don't know what the hell I do with that damn thing. Crap. It's my little radio. That's supposed to be plugged in and charging. I wonder if that's charging. Man, now that's bugging me. Rick, you were going to talk about horses. I was, but now I had that damn thing like right here. That's my extra stuff. Man, I'm really like, I can't believe that thing's usually like right here. Wonder if it's in this box. Oh, that one's empty. What the hell? I can't believe that. It was sitting right here so I would have it if I needed it. Wow. Another mystery. Something else I can blame on Buddy, because I guarantee you he got in here and did something with it. Crazy horse. All right. Well, let's go see the horsies. Bye, Moki. We're going to go see the horsies. I got the... That's open just to let it air out because it's gonna be sunny today. The wind's blowing. It's been shut up all winter. So before those stinking dirt daubers come out, see how the little cow's eating. I feel sorry for those poor little cows. I mean, they got to live with that crap owner. So he just thinks they can eat. I'm like, Richard, why don't you get them a bale of hay so they can eat after the winter and put some weight? Oh, I'm not feeding them. They're going to be moving soon. I'm not going to buy hay and waste it if they don't eat it. Like Richard, they're freaking starving. They'll eat it, believe me. Well, they'll be gone soon. Yeah. I'll be doing a video in a month. They'll still be here. I'm still giving them water. Like I said, he said he fixed it, but he didn't take the time to clean it out. So he says they're not drinking out of it because it's nasty and dirty. I'm like, that might be a clue. I didn't say that, but. So the boys over there eating all those little cows. They already ate. Buddy, quitting so damn fast, you won't be coughing. You end up choking, costing me $300. You boys already ate your hay? They're kind of a pain in the butt. Because if I don't, give them something. So I just gave them like, I opened up a new bale of hay, and the end bale was kind of like sun bleach. So I went, all right, I'll give them that one. And then I kind of split another bale of hay. So they had like a bale and a half, which isn't much for them, but it's a little snack and they like it. They don't look too awful skinny, but their butts are pretty freaking skinny to me. And that little baby is still nursing on her mama. The mama is the little baby looking right here, isn't a year old yet, and that's her mama right behind her, the black one, white one. So, anyway, that's what they're doing. And Buddy will probably find that first. He always sneaks over and finds, hey, even though I'd rather Mr. T find it, because he needs it more. Mr. T, even though he's got some, they're like, damn, we had a nice, peaceful breakfast. Now Dad's coming over with that damn camera. Hi, boys. Whatever, stupid human. Oh, crap. So, their feet look like they could probably use a tram. See how that little ridge on Mr. T's butt line there? See how Buddy is really, like, round? And Mr. T's is kind of, like, not so round. Let me get a good back shot. Mr. T will get all paranoid. He's like, dude, why are you behind me? Look at it. So, there's Mr. T's butt. Being old and less muscly, I really don't like the way his side kind of indents there. But, I mean, he looks like he's got good weight on his neck and shoulders, although he's awful freaking hairy. He's a hairy mess. And Buddy doesn't look like he's hairy, but he gets that thick undercoat. So he's not like, you know, like some dogs, they have short hair, but they're really, really thick. That's kind of Buddy's hair. And then Mr. T's more would be like a long-haired breed dog because he gets a little bit longer hair. So let me get back to Buddy's butt. So I don't know if you can see Mr. T's butt or not. Still got that stupid drainage. I tried that FloNage yesterday. I gotta go in and schedule my live for the gun channel. Just put a little notice so people can come. I might do that at noon or 1. Maybe I'll do it at 1 so I can eat lunch and go up there after lunch. So that's the boys. And the cows, you missed them yelling at me. Because I feed these guys first, then I go back and get them a little hay. See, the problem is I started feeding them that bale of hay that was kind of like dry and wasn't really moldy, but it was really, really dry and dusty. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to break it up. It messes up my lungs and the horses are eating it. So you know what? They'll enjoy it. A little rich alfalfa for them. So I meant to call Richard to see if he closed on his other house. Because his house, something went off and he couldn't close on it. And of course he said as soon as he closes, he's going to move the cattle, but I don't believe him. If he can leave his cattle out here all year, he would. Just so he could say, I've seen him come out here a lot. I mean, I kind of, if I had my person I bought my house from still coming out after 2 weeks, you know, all hours, I'd kind of be like, dude, you're supposed to move out and I'm supposed to move in. This isn't the way it works. If you remember when I moved in, they had that big pink dollhouse over there. And my neighbor said, hey, I wanna sell that to somebody if you don't mind. I go, yeah, I don't care. So I think he ended up selling for $2,000. But it took almost 2 months for him to come get it. And I was finally at the end, I was like, dude, either have somebody come get it or I'm cutting it down. Okay, I'll get them out there. Oh, so they still have water. That's good. So I filled that up last night. They didn't drink it. So now this green grass, you can tell coming out, this fresh spring will sprouts. The horses will be nibbling and the cows will be nibbling on that. So they're getting a lot of moisture in that. I stuck some of those stakes, fruit tree and nut tree, Job stakes that you hammer into the ground. I put a couple of those in the ground and then I watered them. Then I found some poop somewhere and I picked it up and threw it in there. So hopefully my pecan trees will get a little boost if Buddy don't get in there and stomp on them. Check their water. I think I left that other gate open. See, this is how you get, yeah, see that gate? It swung open. So I gotta go back and close that one. They won't go out while they get something to eat. And even if they do get out, they're not gonna. Ever since Mr. T crossed that cattle guard at my neighbor's, I'm a little bit more paranoid about them getting out. Because I don't want them breaking a leg or slipping through, but shit, the way he scurried across that thing, he looked like he was an expert. All right. So that's a peach tree. I put some stakes in that. That's a peach tree. That's a pear tree. I really did a lot of trimming because everybody told me, remember this pear tree right here is where the graft is at. And this is the only one that's producing pears. But this one's really big, the main tree, and it was sucking up all the nutrients. So I really took some big branches off. I would have liked to take this one off and these three off, but I didn't want to do it at one time because if you take too much off, you can kill it. And I took a pretty good bit off here, 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 and here. I mean, I did some pretty good trimming on this side. So hopefully the tree that's producing the pears will grow bigger. It doesn't look like it's budding out yet. Maybe a little bit of a bud. Oh, that one looks like it's got a pretty good little bud on it. So, I don't know if the old peach tree is budding out. Oh yeah, he's got a couple little things coming out there. So I put a couple stakes in that one and watered it. I've got to go through my little stash of food because I've got some old stuff that you got to mix with water and it's supposed to be real organic and good. So I trimmed this one down and I think these are old buds. I don't think those are new. But we'll see. There's a big old ant pad here. I watered it down and put some ant food on it. Looks like it got rid of them. I don't see any ants. I've been through two big bags of ant food trying to get walking around. I bet you I put ant, when I say ant food, it's just ant poison, that ortho mound killer, supposedly kills the mound for 6 months or something. I got it at Home Depot. And so I bet you I have 100. There's probably 30 just in this pasture. Probably 30 out here. And then in the back pasture, there was, God, seemed like at least 50. And I just rode around a golf cart and I'd jump off every once in a while and just sprinkle some ant killer on it. And hopefully it took them out. Usually when I go by the next day and kind of stomp on them, that looks like a little mound. No, it must be an old one. I'll try to find one that. Okay, so I put some ant killer on this one. You can see the little pile of dead ants that are right there, that red stuff. Those are the ants that have eaten it, so I can tell that if I step on it, I shouldn't get any ant movement. I didn't. So that tells me the mound killer worked. That's what I'm up to. Tell the horse stepped in that one. If they walk by stepping and walk, they usually don't get bit too bad. But when their hair gets in there, or those ants come out full blown, they'll still get chewed up. This is an old one from last year. I can tell it's not fresh. The fresh ones look like little beads of dirt. Here's some antology school for you on how to till. So this one, you can tell I got some, you can see the little granules that I put on it. And there shouldn't be any ants in that one now. There isn't. When I sprinkle that on there, I do that and there's ants everywhere. They come out everywhere. Then I sprinkle all that. People tell me I shouldn't do that. The real antologists say, you put them in combat mode when you step on it. They won't eat. I'm like, well, it kills them. This one was pretty bad. Oh, there's still a couple little ants moving around there. So it didn't really kill them all because it was a pretty big mound. I might, that's all the tree limbs that I took off those trees. And I stack them here sometime because in the winter, I always need dried kindling to start my fire. So if I, when I cut these this February, by next December, these will be good and dry and beat down. But sometimes I can't get to the ants. It also gives the rabbit a place to go in and kind of hide and seek shelter under there in case something's chasing it. So, see, there used to be a lot of tree limbs in here. That's why I have it cut. But if I need good kindling, I just grab this too. That helps with the kindling. I wonder if my tires are getting rusty underneath here. Remember I put that wood oil or wood wax on it. I wonder why that isn't Moki Cat. Usually he comes around when I'm walking around and he's bugging me. Oh, he's not bugging me today. I haven't gone for my walk yet. I mean, I'm kind of walking now, but I'm not really walking. See that Moki Cat, if I can sneak up on that crazy cat. There he is. See his little ears. What are you doing, boy? It's like, Dad, I've never seen you over there. What's that Moki Cat doing? What's that little Moki Cat doing? Could he come see his little dad? Hi. Hi, little Moki Cat. Hi, little Moki Cat. What are you doing? How come you're not out here bugging your dad? How come you're not out here bugging your... You're going to get a spanking through this window. You're going to get a big spank. Is that sticking a mosquito inside? Shit, that is a damn mosquito inside there. Look out, Moki. That little sucker will get you. All right, so Moki's in his little window habitat. I haven't seen a rabbit this morning. It's kind of odd because usually he's waiting for his food. I did get out a little bit late this morning. Usually I'm out by 6 or 7. I didn't get out till like 8 this morning. Where are that crazy rabbits at? Where's the little rabbit? You don't want your little breakfast? So he's been kind of busy in here. He's been digging there. Not too bad. He's been digging there. He's got a lot of... I don't know how deep they... Oh, shit. I always hit my damn head on that thing. I keep wanting to remove it. So I'm going to throw a little... He likes a little oats. And he likes a little sweet feed with the horses. So there he'll have a little snack when he comes in here. And the horses aren't around. I can't get to it. All right. So that's my adventures out here. See, that's what they sound like in the morning when they see me wandering around. Like, dude, feed us. See, they're probably want some more damn food. So I trimmed this one. Not this one still looks really cluttery. And again, people go, man, you need to trim that. I go, dude, I take off. I think they say you're not supposed to cut more than a third of the tree down or something like that. And so I really have to mark. Maybe I will do that. I will tie a ribbon on the branches that produce. And then next time I trim, I'll cut those off. These little sacks here. Everybody says, man, you should burn those. I don't know what they are. But you see a few of those on there. Not a lot. I see like 3, but that's too many. I cut a little hole right here so the rabbit can get through. I don't know if you found it. See all the hole? I cut that wire so in case he's outside and he has to get through. If he knows where it's at. I think I did over here too somewhere. Yeah, right there by his little He's been digging there too, you can tell. He dug out this way, and now he's got an escape path here. And then here's, I did another cutout. Is that damn ant bed? I think I fed that one. Okay, there's no ants in there. Alrighty. I turned this one too. This one looks like it's budding pretty good, huh? I don't see any of those little sacks. Oh, I do see one right up there. See that little sucker? I still don't know what these are, but everybody says they're not good. Or I'm gonna kill them. Someday I'm gonna refinish this, paint this with that rust, and make this usable. Because right now I can't even shut it or close it. Look at that big old wasp nest that got built in there years ago. So, what are you mooing about over there, boy? She goes, first of all, I'm a girl. Hey, speaking of the little troublemaker rabbit, what are you doing, Stewie? What are you doing over here? Why's your little ears back? You didn't come over for breakfast this morning. What's going on? Why ain't you bugging Smokey Rabbit? What are you doing? Huh? I know. Eating this little green grass? Is that what you found? All these nice green? He's got all this green stuff coming out, so he's... I thought I already closed that, but I had to check it. All right, well, we'll end it with saying goodbye to the horsies. They probably smell that hay over there for the horses, and that's why they're still hanging out. What are you boys doing? Dad's been walking around yapping for 22 minutes. Hi, boys. Shut up, stupid human. You're not a horse. Poor buddy of Mr. T. They got a rough life. All right, well, in that there. One morning, I'll wake up and these cows will be gone. It'll be like four less critters that I have to have crying for food and feeling bad for. And watering, and I can get my bucket back, and ain't no telling when. Wind's picking up in Texas like it usually does in the damn morning. That's a 4x6 flag instead of a 3x5. If you notice, it has a second little D-ring there that's hanging. So I have a 3x5, a couple 3x5 flags. So that little D-ring that's not being used, or carabiner, or whatever you want to call it, that's for my 3x5 flag. And when I have my 4x6 flags, I have that lower one. So that's why the flag, I like the 4x6 a little bit bigger, because when it gets up there, it just looks better. You can see it better, but you can tell the grass is really green where the water's at, where my sprinklers come on. So I need to go out there, cut that down, and then spray that with some weed killer. But I'm probably gonna have to cut it off. I'm kind of worried about the rabbit going out there, so I want to wait till it gets a little bit greener so he doesn't want to go to that green grass and eat. And I don't see him over here too much unless the horses are here. He doesn't go to this pasture too much, but I still need to, if I don't kill that grass, it gets tall, then when a sprinkler kicks on, it just keeps all the water there and makes a big mud puddle. It doesn't disperse the water because the grass is too long, it blocks it. So that's why it's always a battle to keep that either cut down or killed. And I usually just spray it. All right, well, in that there, nice little Texas day here. Sunday, talk to y'all later.